Okay, so I've got this page in my flowering book. It's just an old book, and I'd stuck a lot of wax paper down previously that I'd painted on. I think, well, it was excess from another project. I think I had an idea to do a page, but it never happened, which is why it was only on the one page. So I've just stuck down some more wax paper that I've painted on this side, and there's some peach and pink paint that I've put on both sides. So what we're going to do next is we're going to grab the gesso and just put it there, and paint palette. I think I could pop some paint, some gesso onto the palette. Now what I'm going for with this page is layers. I've got no idea where it's going to end up, but all I know is I want to create loads and loads of layers, and I want you to be able to see little bits peeking through, but not necessarily everything from the previous layer. So the first thing I'm going to do is grab, where are you? There you are. My brayer, the gesso. Probably put too much gesso out, haven't I? I'm not going to roller it too much. I want some thicker areas. Right, that's that side. I did put some masking tape down the middle because the this page was sort of lifting away. It's where one of the signatures is folded, and it's, yeah, it just lifting off a bit. Oh, actually, that's just about the right amount of gesso. So there we go. That is all I'm going to do for that layer. I'm going to let that dry over here with heat gun, and then I'm gonna come back with some colour, I think. Or, oh no, texture next. I'm gonna put some more texture on. So I'll dry this and we'll be back with the texture layer. So I'm gonna just cut this blue bit off. I'm not sure I want the blue bit. We'll save that for later. I need another spatula, but I don't know where all the spatulas have gone. Oh, I've got to put the next thing in. I don't have another plastic one out. Let's try one of these. Not to think too much on this page. I'm just going to go with it, just go with it. This one's got a lot of paint on it. I've obviously been using it as a stencil, so after a while that paint just looks really cool on it. So really embedded in there. And have a little bit, just a little bit some masking tape here and there. Just because we've already got it down the middle, so. Just make it look more like that's supposed to be there. Okay, and then this tape. Which is not actually all that sticky, so it needs a bit of help. So we're gonna do one more layer of just there with the brayer. Oh, get rid of some of them bits of paper. Perhaps not so much this time. Fabric on my desk for making masks and stuff. Stuck to my brayer. Right. Yeah, you're on video now. It's cat's dinner time. So just do this. Let's dry. Feed the cat. And we'll be back with some colour. Oops. Oh no. Okay. Let's grab some colour. Colour. Oh, someone decided to be noisy. Okay, so I've got this Ducraft Artiste paint. Is it? What's this one called? Is it called Flesh? Yeah, it's called Flesh. Grab a bit of that. I did want a card. Have I got a card? Yeah. Got a card. Now this is the colour that is underneath here, so we'll just bring a bit more of that forward. This is just the first layer of colour. There's going to be, I think I'm going to build darker colours, I think. Still not really got a plan, but. Just a step at a time. And then we're going to put those other two. These are ones are from Tiger. This is like an orangey, peachy colour. Just so it's wet there, so. Just scrape that on, and that's going to create more texture. It's going to catch some of this. It's already there. putting building, building. Yeah, let's try and get some down the middle as well. Nice. And let's grab some of the yellow. A little bit of yellow. Doesn't matter if it mixes a bit with the orange or the peach. Tim Holtz paper dolls or something like that. Maybe some Tim Holtz words. I don't know. We'll see how it evolves. So now I'm going to dry that off and then I'm going to grab some book text and we'll be back with a little bit of that. Here's my little book page. Let's get rid of the edge. And then just tear this into bits. Just throw it down anywhere. And maybe just stick it where it lands. Pretty much, yeah. Yes. Matte medium. This page is probably still a teensy bit damp, but that's okay. So I have this piece of napkin. I've got my ring of braille out of the way in a minute. Bits and pieces up here, out the way. Let's pop the braille away for a minute. We've got this napkin, and it's obviously the inside, the pieces that you don't normally use. You know, the non-colourful pieces that you pull away. And there's two. So, just clear the whole lot down. Yeah, let's just do it that way. Instead of tearing it, cover the whole page. I have glued two pages together to give it a bit of strength because obviously I'm going over it a lot with a lot of mediums and paints, and I'm going to hit it with a lot of stuff, so I wanted it to be a bit stronger, a bit more able to cope with it. So I've just glued two pieces together. And I am going to get that bubbly texture around the edge, but that's fine, I don't mind. It just adds, doesn't it? Get a bit more up there, make sure it's all nicely stuck down. Now this is going to take a while to dry. So what that's going to do is going to add more texture. It's going to push everything back again. As I say, I want layers and layers and layers and layers. It'll probably show more of the background through a little bit when it's dry. It'll start to go a bit more translucent as it dries, hopefully. Some places it might stay quite white, especially if I haven't got enough matte medium on there. And that is fine too. That'll just add to that whole covering up thing. There we go. So I'm going to leave that to dry. Maybe hit it with a heat gun a little bit when I get bored. I'm ready to move on to the next bit. But now I've got to decide what is the next step. That was as far as I planned. So I'll be back very shortly. Right. So. Got some stencils and some paints out. Oh, you know what I haven't found? Going to need just one just there. So I've got some fairly large geometric shapes. Got a dotty one, this one. So this one is Mike Deacon. These are from a pack from eBay. It's just I don't think they're any particular kind of make. This is a Mike Deacon, and I believe these two are Maremi. That one definitely. Really sorry about the noise, guys. Oh no, wait. Yes, 13 arts. So I think I got that off her website, but it's 13 arts. I think. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the. This maybe? It's still a little bit damp, that's okay. I think I'm gonna go this one first. Yep, don't think too much, just go with it. popped a little bit of gesso up here. I'm going to use the little brayer. And I'm just going to probably going to need some more gesso out actually. Gesso. Not aimed to cover the whole page. Try adding a little bit of stamping, I think. Which bit are we going for? Who knows? It's quite a large stamp. Lots of different bits and bobs on it. Stays on, it's not best ink, I have to say, but that's fine. I just want a little bit. It doesn't have to be perfect, and it's not going to be perfect anyway because of all the texture, so I just want bits and bobs peeking through here and there. Excuse the noise, there are kids playing outside. I think someone's flouting the rules and having a Easter party, or, well, you know, kids get together something. But there we go. I'm not going to comment. I'm going to grab the archival black soot. Now I'm going to use martyr stamp. Yes. That's going to give me a bit more. Dig out my other stamps as well. Do I want another layer of gesso before I do that? Maybe. I'm going to use this stamp as well, but I think I'm going to change to the grey, which is it Hickory Smoke? Hickory Smoke. Again, that's a very subtle one. yeah, I feel like it's getting busy again. So, another layer of gesso. I think this time gesso out. I'll put it here. That's probably a lot of gesso. That's fine. So so we'll have some stamps and wax paper, very sticky stamps. Let's have a block, shall we? There I am. These already on this page. It's been a while. I haven't even got the page open in front of me at the moment. Sorry if I'm bouncing and we need to zoom out again. There we go. Get some ink on there. So this is just some wax paper that's already got some paint circles on. I've used a lid of some sort to stamp those circles on. It's just been in my stash for a while. I think I need to get another black ink. They all seem to be a bit grey. Definitely blacks a lot. Okay, and we do the diamonds as phone. There's also some colour on here. I think it's just off spray from some whatever I was doing. I was just spraying something and had this underneath to catch it. Okay. So I think I'm probably going to add some more black paint marks, because I want that real darkness to come through now. What are we going to do? Yep, we found a black paint and something, and we'll carry it. Okay, so I've got this stencil and some black paint and a sponge. Just go through like this. Do some of the lowercase letters. So I've got this already done. We shall use some of that. We're going to use the good old matte medium. Spatula, as long as it's dry. Yes. So for the next step, I'm gonna mix up some glazing medium with some paint, and we have this. It's supposed to be purple, but it's a bit more of a reddish colour to me. It's a Lancôme paint. I've got that upside down, haven't I? Sorry. I'm gonna need quite a bit because we've got a large page, so I've got my acrylic glazing medium. Doing about half and half. Mix it up. And I think I'm gonna do a few excuse me different colours of glazes maybe. Perhaps just a bit more medium. I'll close the lid. Okay, this is a very messy technique. Well, I get very messy doing it anyway. So, hopefully though, it's going to show up some of our texture really nice. So, I'm going to grab a big brush. Big, soft brush. Thin layer, so I don't think this next is going to take long. What we've got to do now is just wait a little while, don't dry it, just let it sit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and wash my brush, and I will be back, and then hopefully should be ready. Move on. So I've got baby wipes, not super wet. I think it's dried out a little bit, but that's good. And then we just gently go in and rub. Now I want the middle to be lighter, so I'm going into the middle first. And just turn the baby wipe. And you can see now that it is picking up the texture, which is brilliant. It's just what we wanted. I found this doll, and then I think I'm going to take this apart. I've done this before. There we go. I'm just going to trim there. around it because there's still, it's very roughly cut out, these butterflies. So get rid of some of that excess. Cut it in half using my good scissors. Okay, and then that means we can put it so that we can see it a bit better. Just poke them out the sides. Nice. I think I want to do my white splatters first though, so let's move her out the way. Just a little bit. No, that should be fine. And some water. Just hoping I don't splash the camera. There we go. Let's dry the splashes off a little bit. I think that's mainly dry, right? And then gel medium. Okay. Grab our lady back and her wings, and that splash is covered in stuff, so we'll use this. Just peel that off a little bit. There we go. Ugh, right. I'm gonna pop the glue on the back of my lady. Just smeared some on the front, and I'll get rid of that in a minute. Okay, so then we will position the wings. And pop her down. Grab a clean baby wipe. Just get rid of the excess. Down for a bit, make sure she grabs. Make it dry up a bit. Let's get rid of my fingerprints all over her face. Okay. then I got some quotes out of the Tim Holtz Snarky collection. Scissors again. So this one says, I'm fabulous. I'm just gonna pop. Oh, this gel medium's really, really yucky now. This one says, I have absolutely no desire to fit in. I admit that my weirdness is above the national average, but I'm comfortable with that. Blob of white pink there that I've just disturbed, so that may have a bit of white on it. Okay, so now all I want to do is put the lid back on here. Just gonna add a little bit of shading down there. Have a water brush. Let's get that going. A little bit too much of that wood in there. That's okay, we can spread it out. feel like she's missing something. So, just give me 1 minute. Okay, so, how about this? Itty bitty crown. Which I can't get off the carrier sheet. Just want to trim it. So that it goes a little bit more. And then I've got some gems. Probably need the drill medium again. Let's see what we got. Purple heart. Can I get into this little tiny packaging? Gonna need some scissors. Let's pop that out there. Tiny bit of gel media. That's that, and then we've got some round ones. Right, let's have a tiny bit of gel media. Really must apologize for the noise. Not much I can do about people being outside. The weather's nice, you see. Right. What about these little triangles? Oh. No, is that going to be a bit big? Oh. Red square. Like it to go that way. There we go. I'm going to leave it at that. Let's have a look at the page as a whole. So yeah, it's a page of many layers. And to say I didn't have any idea where it was going, I'm very happy with the way it's turned out. I think maybe we'll go around the quartz with the white gel pen. A little bit wet. I have to say though, it's working remarkably well. To say it's still wet. Go. I think that's it. So today is the 21st. And that is that. So I hope that wasn't too long for you. I'll probably try and cut a little bit out. Taken me several days. As I say, I really didn't know where I was going with it. Very pleased with it, and I hope you've enjoyed it. I really hope to see you again soon. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.